Guys, welcome back to another video of Clinical Dentistry Hub. I hope you all are doing good. So going on with the cases in day-to-day practices, basically a day before yesterday, I had a call from one of my friends and he said that just perforated the tooth. So these are the common happenings which are happening in your day-to-day practices. So this video might help you how to repair your perforated tooth while doing root canal treatment. So just have a look and watch it completely so that you have a good prognosis tooth in your clinic. So how does it basically happen? Basically, many of us are confused about what basically a perforation means. So if I talk about a perforation, it is basically an artificial communication between the tooth and the सराउंडिंग टिश्यूज, दांत और आसपास के सराउंडिंग टिश्यू के बीच में एक आर्टिफिशियल कम्युनिकेशन बन जाने को परफोरेशन कहते हैं. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट व्हाट आर द बेसिक रीजंस बिहाइंड द कॉज ऑफ दिस परफोरेशन इज, सो फर्स्ट आता है पैथोलॉजिकली. क्या होता है, मेनी केसेस में आपका लार्ज पेरिपाइकल लीजन है, पेरिपाइकल लीजन जो है वो एक्सटेंड करके आपका इधर आ गया और आप यहाँ पे क्लीनिंग शेपिंग कर रहे हैं. क्लीनिंग शेपिंग करते 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 सडनली आपका फाइल स्लिप होके ये हो गया, तो कैनाल किसी और डायरेक्शन से बाहर आया, तो इसको हमने नेम्ड इट एज अ परफोरेशन ऑफ अ टूथ. फिर और कॉज आता है रिजॉर्प्शन. बेसिकली कि जब भी आपका टूथ रिजॉर्व हो रहा है तो इसमें कोई भी आपको एक बैरियर नहीं मिलता है. और फिर देन इट इज केरीज एंड आइट्रोजेनिक प्रोसीजर. आइट्रोजेनिक प्रोसीजर सबसे कॉमनली माना गया है इन द केस ऑफ अ परफोरेशन ऑफ रूट कैनाल फिटेड टूथ. सो बेसिकली इट सेज दैट 10 to 12% of an endodontically treated tooth have undergone a perforation. So, etiology ke baad, hame, what are the factors we should contribute and we should see so that you do not go under a perforation, and what factors is to be considered while performing a reparation of a perforated tooth. So, these are level, location, size and time. Level says that while you have a perforation in your tooth, and it says that perforation can be either in the coronal third, in the middle third and in the apical third. So with the term location, it says that when a perforation is there in the apical third, that means the tooth will have good prognosis. Why? Because if you have a perforation in a coronal third, you will find that it has a communication with the outer surfaces. So the chance of inflammation is very much in these cases, whereas apical portion is all covered, only it is within the tooth, that is perforation is with the surrounding tissues only. So prognosis chances are much better. The second is the location of a perforation. Basically whether the perforation is in the mesial direction, distal direction, lingual direction or the buccal direction. It is said that when you have to do a non-surgical treatment in an endodontically cases, so in that cases location does not matter. Third is the size. Larger the size of the perforation, more worse is the prognosis of the tooth. Then it is the time. Basically, if the perforation has occurred right now, it is best to do the treatment as soon as possible so that when the time will be elapsed, so the communication, it's an artificial communication. That means the tooth has to communicate to the outside environment. So the infection will travel. So how much repair you do, how much antibiotic you placed in, how much triple antibiotic paste you give, the chance of tooth will be in a poor prognosis. And then basically when I was going through one of the article, I basically saw that earlier in the time when newer material was not there, amalgam was the first material when it was used as to repair the perforation in the root canal treatment. Then we have GIC, we have basically most of them, they repair the perforation with the help of gutta percha only. They use thermoplastics and gutta percha, they inject in the canal and the canal gets sealed with the help of sealer over there. Then we have zinc oxide, eugenol, we have composite, we have calcium hydroxide. These are all old material which were available earlier so as to repair the perforation. So the latest available material to us is the biodentine. we have MDA, we have dentine chips, and we have bioceramic. What basically a dentine chips is there? When you are preparing a root canal, so when you are doing a biomechanical preparation, cleaning and shaping of the canal is going on, and you will see you will have a dentinal debris over there. So sometimes there is a dentine chip which comes out of the canal, so you just have to take it out, make a powder form of it, mix it with the distilled water, and can be used as to repair the perforation. The third is the bioceramic. So according to me, which I also use, is the best material to repair a perforation is the MTA. Because what basically MTA, it is very biocompatible. It has no that tissue irritability reaction as with the zinc oxide eugenol is seen. And moreover, when you apply MTA, it leads to the formation of a calcific barrier over here. So agar perforation hua hoga aur canal is like perforated over here, so यहाँ पे MTA place करके calcific barrier मिल जाएगा आपको MTA से. उसके बाद इसका बस यही एक drawback है कि it has a longer setting time. But what basically you have to do is when you are applying MTA in order to repair a perforation, you do not have to just keep on filing it, because इसको set होने में ही it basically initial setting time 3 hours है, but final setting time it takes up to 24 hours of final setting time. So the best of the best material MTA, which holds a promising future in the future dentistry part. So with all these, let us just now talk about what are the prognosis of these perforated tooth. Let's talk about ki ye perforated repaired tooth ka, what are the prognosis of these perforated repaired tooth. So there is a review article by Fersen Tropp. I advise everyone to read this article. It's a very good article which says that if you have a fresh perforation and you repair it at that moment only, the tooth will have a good prognosis. Whereas if you have a old perforation and you are that means you are taking time to repair it, or if you have a referred case jisme perforation hua tha 2 saal pehle 3 saal pehle, so you will have a questionable prognosis. Then it is when you have a small perforation, it has a good prognosis. A large perforation has a questionable prognosis. As I already told you in the location part, the larger the size, the more chances of it to get infected. Then is the coronal perforation, that has a good prognosis, and apical perforation has a very good prognosis. So with this, how basically you will repair a perforated tooth. Likewise, you have a perforation over here and you want to repair the tooth, and these are your canal. One canal is this going, and the second, when you were preparing, it just went out from here, and the third was over here. So what basically is, you just have to insert file in your canal. Just insert a file over here, mix MTA, take a probe or a 8 number file, just carry the mixture over here and just damp it over here, and then apply a then you don't have to irrigate over it. Apply a cotton, give temporary restriction, and send the patient. In next appointment you will see that there is no perforation over here. So this was all about how to repair a perforation while doing a root canal treatment. So if you have any question, you can just put it down in the comment section so that I can answer all your questions. And there is my Instagram page also. You can message me there also if you have any query related to it. And just put it down in the comment section what other videos you want, so that I can make a video on it, which will be helpful to you also and to me also. Please, if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and just click the bell icon so that you don't miss out any important content.